Welcome to Touch Technology Review. In this video, I'm going to share with you my top five title effects in DaVinci Resolve. These are available in both the free and paid version of DaVinci Resolve. So without any further delay, let's get started and check out title effect number one, which is the glitch effect. To access this, click on the titles menu on the left-hand side and click on the text option and drag your text onto the layer above your background layer. Click on the inspector tab on the top right-hand corner and in the rich text dialog box, enter the text that you would like to appear on screen. I'll just use the word glitch text for this example. Then you can choose your desired font from the font family drop-down menu. Click on the effects tab on the left-hand side and you'll see a search box just above. Type in digital glitch. Now, normally you could drag this effect onto clips on your timeline. You'll notice that it doesn't work on a text clip. So in order to make it work, you need to right-click on the text clip and convert it to a compound clip. You can give your new compound clip a name so that you can find it in the media bin later on. Now I'll try and drag the digital glitch across to this element again. And you'll notice that this time it has successfully applied the effect to your title. The next text effect we're going to take a look at is the typewriter effect. To access this feature, you need to click on the titles tab on the left-hand side and click on the text plus tool. So not the previous text tool that we used. Make sure that you've selected text plus. In the inspector tab on the right hand side, go and enter the desired words in the text box. I'm going to use the self-explanatory title, typewriter effect for this example. Then you can go in and change the font, the color, and all the parameters you would like. Scroll down to the write on section, drag the playhead to the very left of the screen. Click on the end frame in the write on section and drag it to the very left and then create a keyframe. Drag the playhead on the main timeline across to the right, maybe 2 to 3 seconds or as long as you would like the effect to transpire. Now go and drag the end frame in the write on section across to the very right and you should see the type on screen reveal completely. Drag the playhead in the main timeline to the left, click on play, and there is your basic typewriter effect. Next, we're going to take a look at how to create a handwriting effect. To do so, we're going to click into the Fusion tab. This is the fourth icon along on the bottom of the screen. The Fusion tab is a powerful feature of DaVinci Resolve, which allows you to put together complex animations and effects within a clip on your timeline. So I've got a background photo here that I took in Venice some years ago, and I'm going to put the typography Venice over the top. To do so, click on the Medium 1 node, and then click on the text option that appears in the icons just above the nodes window. Click on the text node, and then in the text box that appears in the inspector window on the right-hand side, go ahead and enter the desired text. I'll use the word Venice as my title, and I'll go and select a suitable font. I'm going to use one that I downloaded called Zombies. I'll go ahead and make some changes to the size and the tracking. Tracking is the space between each individual letter. Tap on the text node in the nodes window. Go to the effects option at the top of the screen. Add in the search field, type in the word mask paint. Click on mask paint or drag and drop it directly onto the text node. And at this point, you should see an arrow pointing from the mask paint node to the text node as indicated on screen. Make sure that you have the mask paint node selected. Go to the top of the viewer window and select the stroke brush, which is the third one from the left. In the inspector tab on the right-hand side, click on the mask tab and click on invert. This will now reveal the typography on screen. Click on the controls tab. Tap on the brush controls drop down to reveal the brush shape and tablet settings, including the size and softness of the brush. Go ahead and make some adjustments to your brush so that it covers the line of your typography as you're painting over it. So you want it to be a little bit thicker than the outline of the font itself. So I'm just brushing over with my mouse just to see if it's the right size. And that looks pretty good to me. You can see the brush is depicted by a green circle. Once you've adjusted your brush size and you're happy with it, click on the stroke controls option below, and in the drop-down under stroke animation, change it from all frames to right on. Bring your mouse over to the viewer window and position it on the very top left of your typography. Hold down the shift key and start painting out the effect. You need to do this all in one motion, so this might take a little bit of practice before you do your final version, but simply write over each one of the letters as though you're erasing the font from the screen. Once completed, you'll see a whole bunch of keyframes appear just under the main viewer window in the timeline, indicating the animation of your mask. If I click to the very left of the playhead window, click on the play button and you should see the effect on screen, but you'll notice that it's actually happening in reverse. What we have now is the complete title on screen and a gradual erasing of each of the letters. We want the opposite, where we want to start with nothing on screen and gradually reveal each letter one by one. So to do that, we're going to go back to the Inspector tab in the mask sub menu, and we're going to uncheck the invert option. So now when I bring the playhead back to the beginning, you'll see there's no title on screen. If I click on play, it now gradually reveals each one of those letters. However, you'll notice that the animation is occurring in slow motion. We want to speed this up. So to do this, we're going to adjust the keyframe duration. We'll do that by clicking on the keyframes option at the top of the screen. You'll see a keyframes window appear below. Click on the mask paint one layer. Scroll down and click on the stroke one layer to reveal the keyframes. And I can see there's a bit of a gap in the middle of the animation when I was painting that mask. So what I can do here is select the keyframes on the right hand side. They'll turn into yellow to indicate that they've been selected. And then I can just drag those keyframes across to the left to close that gap. And that will help even out the animation. But even so, it's probably still going to be a little bit too slow. So after you've closed in any gaps, you can go ahead and change the speed of the entire sequence of keyframes by selecting them all, then right-clicking and clicking on the time stretching option. Bring the mouse over to the right-hand corner of the last keyframe. Drag your keyframes across to the left. I'm going to drag way across to about a quarter of the duration of the timeline that they were previously set at. Then I'll click on the play button above to preview the animation. And there you have it, a handwritten title effect using DaVinci Resolve. The next effect we're going to cover today is the mirror effect, which gives the illusion of your title sitting on a mirror, similar to this photo where we have a beautiful landscape image of trees with a reflection in the water. So I want to mimic this effect with my typography. Let's start by going to the Fusion tab. Once again, we're going to click on the median one node and click on title. Then we're going to click on the text node, and in the text box, we're going to enter our text. I'll use the word mirror, and I'll go ahead and change the font, adjust the size and the tracking as required, and I'll leave the color to the default white, but of course you can go ahead and change the color if you'd like to. Then I'm going to go on the text node, and I'm going to right-click and select copy. Then I'm going to right click in an empty area of the nodes window and paste the text box. Then I'm going to grab the handle on the right hand side of the new text box and connect it to the handle on the right hand corner of the merge one node. And you'll see we now have a new text box and corresponding merge node. Click on merge node 2, and in the inspector window on the right hand side, we're going to flip this vertically. And we're going to use the center adjustment Y, and we're going to drag the title down below the original text node. I'll drag it so that we have just a little bit of a gap in between the original text and the reflected text. Click on the settings tab, and we're going to change the blend to around 0.6 to reduce the opacity of the reflected text. The choice is yours. You can play around with this blend mode until you have the desired amount of opacity. I will usually select anywhere from 0.6 to 0.5 opacity. Next, go ahead and click on the shear dropdown and adjust the x-axis to around 0.1 or 0.2. Next, we're going to add a mask. So to do this, make sure that you have that second text node selected, which in my case is called text underscore one, and then click on the rectangular mask tool. A mask will be placed over the top of the mirrored text layer. It might not cover the whole text from left to right. So go ahead and drag the bounding box left and right until all of the typography is covered by your mask. Pick up the mask box and move it down until it starts to cut into the base of the typography. So you want it at around the three-quarter mark. You want three-quarters of the mirrored text visible, and the last quarter of the typography should be completely cut off. Obviously, it looks a little bit abrupt right now. So in order to make it a smoother blend, we're going to go into the inspector panel again. Under controls, we're going to adjust the soft edge slider. And you can also readjust the mask as desired until you get the perfect blend with your mirrored text. Next up is the neon title effect. Once again, we're going to go into the fusion tab. We'll select on the median one node and click on the text tool. We'll click on the text node and enter in our title. I'll use the word neon here. Select the font that you'd like to use. Try and use one that has the impression of being a neon sign, for example. I've got one that I downloaded online, simply called Neon. There's plenty of other neon fonts available, which you can download for free if you do a Google search. Go ahead and adjust the size of your title as well as the color. With the text node selected, click on the effects tab, click on open effects, and in the search field, type in Flickr Edition. Drag the Flickr Edition effect in between the text and merge one nodes, and it should automatically create a join between the text and merge one node. So I'll just move them along a little bit so you can see how it should look. You should have your text layer with an arrow to the Flickr Edition node, which then links to the merge one node. Then click on the playhead and let's have a look. It's very subtle when you first apply the effect. So we're going to go into the inspector window on the right hand side, and we're going to change the Flickr type from Flickr Gamma to Flickr Gain, and you can change the range and speed, and you should now see a neon flickering type effect on screen. So you can spend a little bit of time here adjusting the range, speed, smoothness, and all the other parameters until you get the type of flickering that you're after. Now we're going to go and add some glow to our neon effect. So to do that, click on the effects tab above, click on open effects, and then do a search for glow. This time we're going to drag the glow effect in between the merge one and media out node. And this will apply the glow to the typography and the background as well. Tap on the play bar to preview your glow, and then you can click on the inspector tab on the right-hand side, and you can change some of the parameters to increase or decrease the amount of glow according to your preference. Again, no hard and fast rules here. Just adjust until you see the right amount of glow for the signage and background image that you're using. For the final effect, we're going to add a drop shadow to the text one node. So to add a drop shadow, click on the effects option on the top of the screen. Under the open effects section, do a search for drop shadow and drag it in between the text one node and the flicker edition node. I'm going to change the background here so that we can see the drop shadow better to a slightly lighter shade of gray. And now I can adjust all the parameters of the drop shadow, the drop distance, the shadow strength, and the angle to make the drop shadow become more noticeable. So now if we click on play, there you have it, an amazing neon title effect using DaVinci Resolve. If you get to the end of the process and you decide you'd like to change the font color, that's really easy. Click on the first text node, change the color, click on the play button, and you'll now see the neon effect in a different color. Thanks for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, by all means, feel free to hit me up with a like and consider subscribing to the channel. And if you want to see additional content in relation to using DaVinci Resolve and other video editing programs, I'll leave some links to additional videos in the description box below. If you have any comments or questions on the content you've seen today, you're also welcome to drop those in the comments box below, and I'll endeavor to get back to you as soon as possible. See you on the next one. Bye for now.